my shame, draw me with love and kindness, and wash whiter than snow. You have redeemed and made me whole. In grace, you've shown me grace. You've lifted my shame. You've drawn me with love and kindness and washed whiter than snow. You have redeemed. Trying to overdo death.
give me Jesus.
Church experience, when the Holy Spirit wanted to teach me more. The same Spirit that lives in you is the Spirit that raised Christ from the dead.
We are driven by a passion to raise up revivalists who will go into all the world, live the gospel, and release the kingdom into every sphere of influence. A world transformed through you. We believe we owe the world an encounter with God. Will you say yes?
Well, hello, hello, on campus students. Give me a little shout here in the room. Yes. Guys, welcome online. My name is Peter Mattis. I'm a pastor here at Bethel Church. We are so honored and privileged to have you joining us here at the Encounter Room. We have a room full of our BSSM, Bethel School Supernatural Ministry students who have already been praying for you. Yes, I mean you, right where you're at, driving your car or at home doing the dishes or changing a diaper or listening at work on a computer. We have been praying for you right now. We are going to spend the next hour and a half diving into the presence of the Lord. We are going to spend the next hour and a half waiting on Him and seeing where He leads, and we really are hungry and expecting to see Him show up. I remember 10 years ago, I was listening to a revival service in Florida, Lakeland Revival, and I was in my dorm room listening, and I felt so disconnected. I really wanted to be there in person, but the Lord showed up in my dorm room, and I started dancing around. I didn't have anything. I needed something to grab, so I think I grabbed an iPod cord, not iPhone cord, back in the day. I grabbed the iPhone, and I was like swinging it around, and I feel like wherever you are at, in your room or your car, if you need to do that in your car, you better pull over for a second. But if you're doing the dishes or you're at work right now, or maybe you're even streaming this back again and you're listening back to this in coming days, the Spirit of God is not limited by location or time. He's not. The man with the greatest faith was the centurion in the Bible, and that was because he believed Jesus, simply his words that would go forth and heal. That is what's happening today. We're so excited, honestly, to have you here. I really believe the presence of God is going to show up in rooms and in cars and in just little AirPods and in your ears. I feel like people like the Spirit, the tangible glory of God, the presence of God that moves and breathes and lives on the inside of you if you know Him, is going to come out. It's going to fill rooms. I feel like even people maybe next door to you, or you're watching in your living room and someone in the office next to you or the room or the kitchen next to you is gonna hear what's happening and just be inclined. I feel like salvations are gonna happen. People are gonna come to know Jesus. Physical bodies are gonna be healed. Like minds, even mental complications, like mental illness, things that have been going on. If you've been shut up in your home for the past 2 years, you haven't been out with other people into the outside world, I feel like freedom is gonna come to you and loneliness is gonna be swallowed up in a moment. We're here to praise the name of the Lord, and we believe that prayer and praise is a thing that beckons Him. Our job is simply to turn our face to Him. That's it. There's nothing else on you. There's no other pressure. We just turn. So right now, if you're in the room, could you stand? I would encourage you, online community, if you're watching, to move if you need to. You can sometimes check out while you're doing stuff, but if you need to move or stand or raise your hands, if you're driving the car, open the sunroof and put your hands out through the sunroof, like wherever you're at, would you open up your body as well as your heart and your mind, your spirit to receive him? I believe the presence of the Lord is going to be exported from this room, yes, but even more than that, there's almost gonna be a curtain that's pulled back in your heart and in your mind, and you're gonna feel the presence of the Lord enter into your room where you're at right now, wherever you're listening to this. Maybe you're out on a walk and you're listening on the outside. You guys ready? Why don't we just open up our hands? If you're online, you can open up your hands. Just a little sign that we are ready to receive the presence of God. Whew. In a second, I'm gonna have everyone in this room raise their voice, but I want you to raise your voice as well if you're watching online. It's one thing just to watch somebody else praise. It's another thing for you to enter in. It's another thing for us to go all together in as one, praising the name of the Lord. Because wherever people are gathered under his name, whether you're in Redding, California, or you're somewhere else across the world, doesn't matter where you're at. He is not limited by location. The Spirit of God alive in me and alive in these people in this room is the same Spirit that raised Christ Jesus from the dead. We're in Holy Week this week, right? And he's alive inside of you if you know him. If you don't know him, man, you just invite him. Just say his name, Jesus. If you don't know what I'm talking about, that's okay to say the name Jesus, and he'll walk into your room like this presence, this peace, this calm will walk into your room. We believe that right now. Holy Spirit, would you walk into rooms? Spirit of God, right now, would you walk into this room? Would you walk into our minds? Would you walk into our eyes, into our ears, into our nose, and be able to smell you and taste you and feel you, see you, God? Would you be a real God, not just a sanctuary room, God? Would you be a doing the dishes in the moment, God? Would you be a changing the diaper on the Excel form, on a computer, God? Would you invade spaces right now? Guys in this room, would you lift your voice? If you're at home, would you lift your voice with us? Praise, praise is the highway. Praise is the highway that we take. Lift your voice right now with me, right now, out loud. Lift your voice. Doesn't matter how it sounds, lift your voice. There it is, there it is. We welcome you, beautiful Jesus. We welcome you, our beautiful Savior and friend. Oh, our resurrected Jesus, we follow you. We follow you, our beautiful, kind Lord. We follow you, Holy Spirit. Come on, lift your voice.
fragrance, we will bring you our praise.
Yes, we will.
Yes, we will.
Let the sound of our worship rise beyond this room as we bring you our praise.
We'll bring you.
Let it be a sweet, sweet sound in your ear, Lord. As your people all together bring your praise, we will bring you our praise. We will bring you our praise. We will bring you our praise.
We're all for you.
Here we are.
On your heart. Who sits there? Does worry sit there? Does an ideal life sit there? Does a dream sit there? Or does Jesus sit there? He's calling you home today. You don't have to fix your life. You don't have to get things in order. You just have to come. There's not going to be bigger arms open to you. There's not going to be a heart that beats faster for you. There's not going to be eyes that lock on to your eyes like any other person or anything that would, you would have their attention except Jesus. Come home. Quit running. Quit trying to prove. Quit striving and just come home. God wants you home, where you belong. You'll feel the most love you've ever felt before. Things will melt away that you thought you could never get away from or get rid of. You'll hear His voice and you'll hear, I love you. You'll hear, I see you. You'll hear, I know you. So whether wherever you're in this room or you're online or you're listening, God's calling you home right now. He wants to sit on that throne. He wants to lead you. He wants to guide you. He wants to care for you. And on top of that, the things you care for, He cares about. My mom prayed for my dad for the first 19 years of their marriage. He wasn't a Christian. And on one night in August of 1994, my dad walked an altar. And his oldest son, his middle son, and his youngest son followed him. In one night, four out of the five members of our household, the other one was praying, all came to know Jesus. And so also, I feel like there's some praying grandmothers in here and online. You've become weary and well-doing. You're like, I don't know if this is possible. There's some brothers and sisters that you've been praying for your siblings to get saved. There's some mothers and fathers you've been praying and crying out for your college student. God hears your prayers. And He's releasing just a fresh wind to you today to begin to experience just Him taking that burden. Him partnering with you to see your loved ones come home. I see Jason's coming home today. I see a Claire coming home today. I see a Roger coming home today. So Father, we just thank You right now. So if this is you, you're like, for some reason I know that Jesus isn't on the throne of my heart, but today I want to make that happen. I want you just to put your hand on your heart right now, wherever you're at, online, at home, in the office, like we've been saying, or you're hearing this later on, just put your heart on your throne and say, God, this is where You belong. This is where You belong. Have my life. I'll follow You. I'll trust You. I'll look to You, knowing that You're the hands I want to commit my life to. I heard a preacher say one time that never trust a man who has no scars because they've never been through anything. Well, we serve a resurrected Jesus who still has scars on His hands. He can be trusted. You can give everything to Him and He can be trusted with it. So, Father, we just give our lives to You right now. Lord, we open up our hearts, our minds. Lord, wherever we're at right now, I ask that Your presence would flood us right now. Lord, and for those that are contending for salvation, God, Lord, we just say that we would not grow weary in well-doing. Lord, that You would give us a fight that we never had before to contend and pray for salvation, God. They're coming home, God. They're coming home, God, to You. So, Lord, we thank You for this, Lord. And Lord, we say, have Your way. Do what You want. Lord, take all the things away from us that we couldn't take from ourselves. We give You our lives in Jesus' name. Amen.
So right now, on the chat online, would you type in a person that needs salvation? If you know them, a friend, a family member, type their name in right now in the chat. Type their name in. We're going to contend and pray for salvation right now. If you just need to come back to the Lord and you've been with Him before, you know Him, but you need to resurrender again, do that again right now. But type names into the chat right now. We're going to see salvations come. I feel like even text messages and phone calls are going to start coming through right now. We're going to pray for salvation. Put their name in the chat right now, wherever you're at. Let's keep going.
Salvation, 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 we release it. Salvation, is our covenant with you. That we would come with empty vessels and you would fill them. You're gonna fill them. Oh, you're gonna fill us.
We are the empty vessels. And you're gonna fill
you're
us.
You're gonna fill us.
During the COVID season, a lot of isolation happened. Did anybody feel that isolation in the room, online? Do you feel that man, I'm disconnected from people. I might feel disconnected from the body of Christ. I might feel disconnected from my brothers and sisters. And as we were praying for today, I felt like God wanted to come in and deal with things that came in at that time when we were isolated, right? The things that came in, things in our minds, things, even like thoughts and ways that we never thought before, but those thoughts came in and started to take over us. Things like depression, things like anxiety, fear. The enemy just loved to jump on that isolation. He loved to jump on that isolation. But today I felt like as we make space, he's gonna pour himself in. And those things are actually gonna come out. And where you're at in your room right now, at home, in the office, just let's just take a minute and actually create that space. And I saw us actually doing an exchange, like an Isaiah 61 exchange, where we give him ashes and he gives us beauty. Where we give him mourning, the struggle, the depression, the challenge, the difficulty, and he puts himself inside of us. So right now, wherever you're at, it might be addiction that came in, isolation that caused addiction, or maybe addiction expanded in your life. God is gonna break that off today. He's gonna break that off today. So right now, close your eyes. All that stuff that's come in, that anxiety, that fear, it might be depression, it might be, I don't know, I've been isolated for so long, I don't know how to socialize or reconnect. I feel awkward even walking in a room with people. It might be stuff you never wanted to come in, but it came in during this time. Today, God's gonna set you free. So take those things, like almost imagine them in your hand. Sometimes it actually takes on something. It looks like mud or muck, or it looks like chains, or it looks like, could look like anything. I actually saw a syringe right as I closed my eyes. It might look like a heavy rock. It might look like a snake. It could look like different things. Take those things. And just let go of them. Like, almost like toss them at Jesus. Toss them at the cross. Things are coming to life. So we toss those things at your feet right now, Jesus. Those weights, those chains, that heaviness, that depression, that fear, that anxiety, that worry. Even I feel like God's breaking bipolar. It's like we started having just a totally different set of voices in our head, and he's breaking that off right now. And he's coming in and he's replacing those things.
Yeah, and just as we're giving the Lord something, he wants to give us something in return. And just as we were worshiping and talking about making space for God, I was just connecting so strong with the idea that God's presence has a substance. Yes. God's presence is a substance. It's something that translates from the spirit realm into this earthly realm that we're in. And when we welcome and make space for him to come, things have to change. They have to change. They can't stay the same. And so just as we've given him things, the Lord wants to come. We can welcome the Holy Spirit to come and speak to us about what he wants to give us in exchange. You know, it says in Isaiah, he gives us the oil of joy instead of mourning, the spirit of praise instead of heaviness. And the Lord wants to come and give you something of him in exchange. His Holy Spirit has a substance. And Jesus said, I have to go. It is good that I go, because then the Comforter will come. The Holy Spirit will come. And he wants to come. He wants to come. And that's why we're singing this song about creating space for him. And I just saw, even as our incredible audience online, just as you're, whatever you're doing in your day, to take a moment, if you can, and pay attention, give attention to what the Holy Spirit wants to do and give you something in exchange. So if you can, just take a minute and let him reveal to you what he wants to give you in exchange. What he does is very real.
So let's just take, we're going to take just 30 to 60 seconds right now. If you have courage and you're online and you want to say, you know what, this is the thing that I want to get rid of, you can type that in the chat. Type that in the chat. Say, I'm done with this depression. It's like an actual act of, it's vulnerable to say, I have this and I'm done with it. But type it in the chat as an act of faith that God's gonna come and replace that. And then as God speaks to you, what he's giving you in exchange, type that in the chat too. What you gave and what you received. So let's just take a minute right now. Give and receive.
I just saw hope coming into people where they had been hopeless before. And I just saw some people receive an image in their mind, like a picture the Lord just revealed to you, and hope just came in. I just bless those things that the Lord has revealed to you. I saw it, maybe somebody didn't see a picture, but they did see, or they felt actually a shift inside their spirit when they were just taking that moment. And right now, in Jesus' name, I declare comfort, the comfort of the Holy Spirit over you all.
Yes.
For every single thing that has been difficult in the last while, the Lord is sending such deep comfort to swallow that up. Thank you, God, for your comfort that swallows up heartache, difficulty, despair. Your comfort is healing, powerful, life-changing. We receive it in Jesus' name. Amen.
searching for a heart is your reward.
Then I am.
If you're searching for a heart is your reward, look no further, Lord. If you're searching for a heart is your reward. If you're searching for a heart is your reward, here's all my heart. Searching for a heart,
searching for a vessel to fill.
Here's all of me, Lord. If you're searching for a heart, is your reward. If you're searching for a heart, is your reward. Then I am.
Right now, wherever you're at, if you can hear my voice, just close your eyes. And I want you just to literally reach your hand out and ask Jesus to come and fill it. Whatever you're doing right now, just reach your simple hand out. It's just simple reach. We reach, he jumps off the porch and he runs. We simply turn and he covers the space in between. Holy Spirit, we want you. We want you. Just put that on your lips. We want you. I want you, God. Holy Spirit, we're empty cups. Come and fill us. Come and fill us. Just one touch from you. Just put it on your lips right now. Where if you can hear my voice, just say, Holy Spirit, come. Say it out loud. Holy Spirit, come. One touch from you and everything shifts. Holy Spirit, come. Say it again. We're simple little open vessels for you, God.
Holy Spirit,
Spirit of God, come and fill. Just invite him in your own words right now. Pause and invite him in your own words. We're your vessel. We're empty cups. You're the big pitcher. We're empty cups. You're the ocean. We're empty cups. Come and fill us. Just invite him to come right now. In your own words, Holy Spirit, come and touch my body. Touch my mind. Touch my soul, my heart. Where there was confusion, touch my mind right now, God.
Holy Spirit,
Holy Spirit, come. Just invite him right now in your own ways. Call out to him in your own voice, your own voice. Call out to him right now. Come on, use your voice out loud.
I am your vessel. Holy Spirit, come. I am your vessel. I am your vessel.
I am your vessel.
I am your vessel.
Fill my cup.
If you're searching for a vessel, Lord, I'll be your vessel.
outstretched arm. You are enough. And you don't withhold.
You are enough.
With an outstretched arm, you don't withhold. And my cup is running, 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 running over. My cup is running.
Surely goodness and mercy will follow me all the days of my life. All the days of my life, surely goodness and mercy will follow me. You anoint my head with oil, my cup overflows. Holy Spirit, you are more than enough. You are more than enough. You not only satisfy, you are more. You are lavish and abundant. You're excessive. You're more than enough.
You anoint me with oil.
Holy Spirit, right now, if you can hear my voice, Holy Spirit, would you anoint heads with oil all across the world right now? In cars and in living rooms, in kitchens, outside on walks, working with kids, on computers. If you can hear my voice, would the anointing of Jesus land upon you right now? Would your cup overflow? The mark of Jesus is excessive overflow, more than enough. He's not a half full God, he's a full God all the way. Spirit of God, would you land on bodies right now? Physically, would you heal bodies right now? Bones and tendons and backs and organs, chronic diseases, terminal diseases right now, would you heal in the name of Jesus? Would you heal minds right now, like we were singing earlier, over conditions that maybe doctors said were incurable? Right now, would you heal minds? Ooh. Spirit of God, would you woo people to your heart right now? The tangible presence, the glory of God, would you beckon them in and woo them into you? The kindness of your smile. Jesus, we love you. Can we sing that one more time? My cup is running over.
Running, running, running over.
Can we just join and sing this?
My cup is running, 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 running over.
It really is.
My cup is running, 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 running over. Yes, it is. My cup is running, running,
oh, it's running,
running, running over.
More than enough.
My cup is running, 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 running.
It might make a mess, it might get on the floor, but it's
my
running over.
My cup is running, 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 running over.
Yeah, just inhale him right now. Inhale
my
him.
My cup is running, 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 running over.
Oh, inhale right now the presence
my
of God.
My cup is running, 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 running over.
Stand with me if you're able to in your room right now. Stand with me.
Running, running.
you so much for joining our encounter room. There is a link beneath the YouTube right now in the description box. If you click that link, we have hosts of students who are hungry and awaiting and ready to prophesy over you and to pour the Spirit of God into you right now. If you click that link, it's going to also be in the chat. You can click that link and it will take you over to Zoom. That's a different web browser where you'll click that link. It will pop you into a Zoom room. We have students who are waiting and ready to prophesy over you right now. Please click that link. There's a space is limited, but if you click that link right now, we want to prophesy and pray over you. Partner with what the Holy Spirit was doing inside of you during the last hour and a half. We love you so much. It has been a true honor and privilege to run after the Lord with you. Thank you for joining us. Why don't you just give up a shout of praise, a lift up a hand, clap in this place. We love you, Jesus. Thanks so much, guys. Thanks for joining us, and we'll see you next time. Bless you.
And through tears of joy, I lift my voice in everlasting praise. Hallelujah. Christ is risen from the grave.
Sing it again.
Oh, death, where is your sting? Oh, fear, where is your power? The mighty King of kings has disarmed you. Delivered and redeemed. Eternal life is ours. Oh, praise his name forever. Hallelujah. Christ is risen from the grave. Hallelujah. Christ is risen from the grave. And all throughout eternity, our song will be the same. Sing hallelujah. Christ is risen from the grave.
Hallelujah. Christ is risen from the grave. Hallelujah. Christ is risen from the grave. And all throughout eternity, our song will be the same. Hallelujah. Christ is risen from the grave.
A high.